dancing to the Jailhouse Rock. Well, howdy, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome this week to Jailhouse Rock. Yes, as you can see, here I am in jail. Joliet, yes. And we're at Mark's Crazy Lockdown Quizzes. And this week it is an Elvis week. Yes, Elvis, the king of rock and roll. So what delights do we have in store for you this evening? I don't know, tell me. Well, today, Mark, we have 4 rounds of questions. Question 1, round 1 is general knowledge, as usual. Always is general knowledge. Round 2 is called rock and rolls. Rock and rolls. Number 3 is called the king of rock and roll. So that's obviously about Elvis. And round 4 is a music round. I'm all shook up. All shook up. Music round. What's it going to be about? I don't know. So, some birthdays this week. We've got Judith Thomas. Happy birthday, Jude. Yes, Judith, a.k.a. Vowels. Judith. We've got Spencer Collier. Spence. We have Nicola Jones. Jonesy. Nick. We've got Tracy Godfrey. Mama G. Mama. And we've got Julie Merrick. Yes. So, all of you can have a little rendition from me. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, all of you lot. Happy birthday to you. And last week's winners, joint winners, was Watkins from Tonga, Pandy, Revile. They were joint winners with somebody else, and we don't care who that was anyway. It doesn't really matter. They were joint winners. They've won luxury apartment in the Bahamas for 14 weeks. Yes, fantastic. So, you've helped us raise £310 so far. £310. We're going to put that to good cause coming through to Christmas. Want you to keep donating via our Just Giving page. Okay, Mark's Crazy Lockdown Quizzes. I think this is going to keep falling down all day. We're going to do something really special for Christmas. We need your help to do it. We're going to help some children over Christmas with some surprises. Okay, are we all ready? And we hope you enjoy what we've been doing for you, okay? So here we go. Round 1, general knowledge. That's an old one. Round 1, question 1. What type of creature is a leatherback? What type of creature is a leatherback? That's question 1. Leatherback. Sure is, Mama. Sure is. That's doing my nutting. That's doing my Sweden already. Sure is, Mama. Question 2. What star sign would you be if you were born on June the 1st? Yes. What star sign would you be if you were born on June the 1st? I don't know. Maybe you know. Who knows? June the 1st, where are you? Question 3. According to the legend, who was Peeping Tom peeping at? Who was Peeping Tom peeping at? That's question 3. Oh, do my nut. Need to speak to the makeup department. Not doing their job properly. That was question 3. According to the legend, who was Peeping Tom peeping at? He was peeping at someone. The reason I'm doing that is there's wax and gel all over my hands. Question 4. What is the name of the three-dimensional image created by a laser beam? A laser beam. With laser with sharks. What is the name of a three-dimensional image created by a laser beam? Okay. That's question 4. Question 4. You know, it's an unbelievable resemblance to the king. Question 5. Which king turned everything he touched into gold? Which king turned everything he touched into gold? Wish I could do that now. Ooh. Which king turned everything he touched into gold? That's question 5. Question 6. What colour are the geography questions in the game of Trivial Pursuit? What colour are the geography questions in the game of Trivial Pursuit? You know the little cheeses? Little cheeses you get? What colour are the geography ones? Yeah. As you're all running upstairs to get the Trivial Pursuit board out, have a quick look. Cheaters! Question 7. What do you call a revolving tray in the centre of a table? What do you call the revolving tray in the centre of a table?
Mama, you know.
What do you call the revolving tray in the centre of a table? That's question 7. Question 8. Which famous detective solves the crime in The Death on the Nile? Which famous detective solves the crime in The Death on the Nile? Don't know. Well, I do, but do you know? Because there's a point writing on it. Blinking here. Question 9. How many hours are there in a week? How many hours in a week? Question 9. Question 10. Which nursery rhyme character went to Gloucester in a shower of rain? I haven't got a clue. Never heard this. My mother never told me that one. Which nursery rhyme character went to Gloucester in a shower of rain? If you know that one, then you learned more than me, than I did as a kid. That's question 10. Are we ready for the answers? Question 1. What type of creature is a leatherback? Well, it's a turtle.
Yeah, mama.
It's a turtle. Question 2. What star sign would you be if you were born on June the 1st? That's Gemini, the twins. The twins, Gemini. That's question 2. Question 3. According to the legend, who was Peeping Tom peeping at? Well, it was Lady Godiva. Lady Godiva in the nude with nothing on. That's question 3. Question 4. What is the name of a three-dimensional image created by a laser beam? That's a hologram. Yes, a hologram. Question 5. Which king turned everything he touched into gold? Well, that's Midas. Midas touched everything he touched, it went to gold. God bless him. Shame we don't know him now. Question 6. What colour are the geography questions in the game of Trivial Pursuit? Blue. Blue.
Blue Christmas without you. Blue.
Yeah, that was number 6. Blue. Question 7. What do you call a revolving tray in the centre of a table? It's a lazy sod. Sorry, Lazy Susan. Lazy Susan we were looking for. Question 8. Which famous detective solves the crime in The Death on the Nile? Was Hercule Poirot. Hercule Poirot. That was number 8. Number 9, how many hours in a week? 168.
Mum.
168. Question 10. Which nursery rhyme character went to Gloucester in a shower of rain? Well, it's Dr. Foster. I don't know where that came from because I've never heard of it as a kid. I've never heard of Dr. Foster went to Gloucester in a shower of rain. Send your answers to me privately if you know what I'm talking about. Or whether I went to the wrong school that you guys did, because I never heard that one. So, there we go. That's question 10. That's the end of the first round of general knowledge. Lions ain't the kind you love enough. So, see this little teddy bear? Listen, we do a thing called TLC, that's Teddy's Loving Care. We give these to hospitals. If we donate one teddy bear, we pay for one teddy bear £5, we donate 3 teddy bears to hospital. All of children are going to hospital A&E, they get one of these teddy bears. May even do that for Christmas. There we go. TLC appeal. Support us. If you want to know more about it, contact me. I'll tell you all about the TLC Teddy Loving Bears. There we go. Right. Round 2. It's called Rock and Roll. Rock and Roll, Mama. Oh, yeah, Mama. Rock and Roll. Here we go. Question 1. Which rock star played Jareth the Goblin King in the movie Labyrinth? Question 1. Which rock star played Jareth the Goblin King in the movie Labyrinth? Oh yeah, Sweet Mama. Sweet Mama Ruth. Question 2. Which song from Bill Haley and the Comets was introduced into the Grammy Hall of Fame? Was it A, Rock Around the Clock? Was it B? See you later, alligator. Was it C? Shake, rattle, and roll. That was question 2. Don't ask me to repeat that one. Question 3. Which group claimed after visiting the House of the Rising Sun that we got to get out of this place because it's my life? That's question 3. Which group claimed after visiting the House of the Rising Sun that we got to get out of this place because it's my life? Okay, that's question 3. Question 4. Ozzy Osbourne was the lead singer of which group? Ozzy Osbourne was the lead singer of which group? That's number 4. All this is about rock and roll. The true legends of rock and roll. Yes, you know it. Number 5. Originally named Force, which Swedish rock band recorded the popular song Final Countdown? Which group named Force originally? They were Swedish. They recorded the popular song The Final Countdown. What were they called now? Question 6. What band is known for its 2 front men wearing very long beards? Which band is known for its 2 front men playing guitars, very long beards? All rock and roll. Rock and roll, baby. It's the business. Oh, mama. All
makeup, makeup.
Makeup. There we go. Sort it out. Sort it out. Just poke me in the eye. Yes, mama.
I don't think it's going to work.
There we go. Oh, mama. You know it, mama. I don't know what that was. I don't even know why I did that. Walk This Way. What band recorded the rock classic Walk This Way? Probably rock and roll, you know. There we go. Question 8. Who's nicknamed the boss? Yeah.
Me.
I'm the king. No, you're not the boss.
I am the boss.
Who's nicknamed the boss? Okay. I'm the king. Who's the boss? Question 9. Who's the lead vocalist of Nirvana? Who's the lead vocalist of Nirvana? That's question 9. The lead vocalist of Nirvana. And question 10. Which rock band is well known for the stage makeup and costumes? Is it A, Linkin Park? Is it B, Kiss? Is it C, AC/DC? Question 10. Which rock band is well known for the stage makeup and costumes? A, Linkin Park. B, Kiss. C, AC/DC. A, B, or C? I don't know. That's question 10. Who cares, Mama? Oh yeah, Mama. You know you love the Mama. Here we go. Question 1. Which rock star played Jareth, the Goblin King, in the movie Labyrinth? Well, that was David Bowie. Question 2. Which song from Bill Haley and the Comets introduced into the Grammy Hall of Fame? Well, it was A, Rock Around the Clock. Question 3. Which group claimed after visiting the House of the Rising Sun that we've got to get out of this place because it's my life? Well, that was The Animals. Question 4. Ozzy Osbourne was the lead singer of which group? Black Sabbath. Yes, Black Sabbath. Question 5. Originally named Force, which Swedish rock band recorded the popular song The Final Countdown? Again. Europe, we were looking for. Yes. Question 6. What band is known for its two front men wearing very long beards? That's ZZ Top. ZZ Top. Question 7. What band recorded the rock classic Walk This Way? Aerosmith I was looking for. I don't know why she's playing it again. I'm telling you the answers. Question 8. Who's nicknamed the boss? Bruce Springsteen is the boss. I'm the king. He's the boss. Question 9. Who's the lead vocalist of Nirvana? And that's Kurt Cobain. Kurt Cobain, lead singer of Nirvana. And question 10. Which rock band's well known for the stage makeup and costumes? Well, it was B, Kiss. Kiss, yes, you remember them all. So, end of round 2, rock and roll. We ready for round 3, the king of rock.
I know, Mama. Hello, you're through to the Elvis, the king, the master. Yeah, man, true man, yeah, Mom. Hi there, Mom. Yes, Mom, yeah, hi, Mom, yes, how are you doing? Yes, Mom. I'm doing from the jail, yeah, Mom, yeah, true, yeah, Graceland, yeah.
What do you mean, act your age? I am acting my age. I'm doing it, Mom, you know what I mean? That's what I'm doing. And I want to ask you a question. What's this Dr. Foster thing as a nursery rhyme I'm supposed to have learned? I've never heard of it before. Where did that come from? There we go. Never mind. Anyway, nice to speak to you again, Mum. Take care. Bye. Props department, yet again. Do you know, if you pay peanuts, you get monkeys. Do you know? Right, round 3. We may get there one week. We may have our own studio. We may have a life, you know, it may get better. And then again, it may not. So, round 3 is King of Rock and Roll. 10 questions all about...
Yeah, Mama. It's Elvis. It surely is.
Question 1. What is Elvis's middle name? Is it A, Theodore? Is it B, Aaron? Or is it C, James? That's question 1. What's Elvis's middle name? Theodore, Aaron, or James? Question 1. Question 2.
What did Elvis and Michael Jackson have in common? Bonus point if there's a glove involved. Same as my mother. What did Elvis and Michael Jackson have in common? Question two. Question three. What was the name of Elvis's wife? What was the name of Elvis's wife? That's number three. Question four. What was the only product ever promoted by Elvis? What was the only product ever promoted by Elvis? Was it A, donuts? Was it B, jeans? Or was it C, a car? A, B, or C? Donuts, jeans, or a car? The only product he ever endorsed. That was question four. Question five. Which of the Beatles' songs did Elvis cover with slightly different lyrics? Which of the Beatles' songs did Elvis cover with slightly different lyrics? That's question five. Just feel, you just gotta sway to the music. Yeah, only fools rush in. So, number six, Lisa Marie, Elvis's daughter, currently owns her father's mansion. What's it called? Yes, I've given you a clue to that one.
No, we actually gave him the answer a minute ago.
That's question six. Lisa Marie, Elvis's daughter, currently owns her father's mansion. What's it called? Question seven. Around how many songs did he record? Is it A, 84? Is it B, 211? Or was it C, 710? How many songs did Elvis record? A, 84. B, 211. Or C, 710? That's question seven. Question eight. What was Elvis Presley's first number one single? Question eight. What was Elvis's first number one single? Number one.
Sure is, Mama.
Question eight. Question nine, even. That comes after eight. Nine. Elvis was a practitioner of which martial art? Elvis was a practitioner of which martial art? That's question nine. That's question nine. Question 10. What colour are the suede shoes? What colour are the suede shoes? That's question 10. So, should know that one. That was an easy one. Back to question one. Question one, what was Elvis's middle name? It's Aaron. Aaron is Elvis's middle name. Elvis Aaron Presley. Yes. Question two. What did Elvis and Michael Jackson have in common? Well, as long as having a white glove, they both owned a chimpanzee. They both had chimpanzees, yes. Did you know that? No, I didn't either. They both had a chimpanzee. Question three. What was the name of Elvis's wife? Well, it was Priscilla. Priscilla Presley. Yes. I think she was on Falcon Crest, or was she Dynasty or something like that? What? Dallas. One of them.
Was from Queen of the Desert?
No. Question four. What was the only product ever promoted by Elvis? Well, it was A, Southern Made Donuts. Donuts were the only product he ever endorsed. Just like that. Fat Elvis. Oh, hey, Bayek. Fat Elvis from Northampton. Hey, Bayek. Question 5. Which of the Beatles songs did Elvis cover with slightly different lyrics? Hey Jude. Yes. Hey Jude, make it better. Take a sad song and make it better. Just for you, Judith Thomas, a.k.a. Bowles. Just for you. Hey Jude. Ah. So, there we go. Question 6. Lisa Marie, Elvis's daughter, currently owns her father's mansion. What's it called? Graceland. Yes, I told you earlier, Muppets. Graceland. Question 7. How many songs did he record? Well, surprisingly enough, it was 710 songs. 710 songs he recorded. Question 8. What was Elvis's first number one single? Let me tell you, buckets of it out the back. Question 9. It was Heartbreak Hotel answer to question 8. Question 9. Elvis was a practitioner of which martial art? Karate. Yes. Lots of wax on, wax off. Karate. And question 10. What colour are the suede shoes? Well, they are... Blue suede shoes. Yes. That's the end of round 3. I'm gone. Tonight we've got a great music round. Yes, all a little bit of Hawaii going on there, a little bit of Lays and all of that. We're gonna do, I'm gonna play some songs.
Don't break this.
I won't break this guitar. No, I won't. I won't break this one. Promise you. So I'm gonna play some music. Okay, you have to guess the artist and the song. Are you ready? Are we ready? Yes, here we go. Number one. Two.
you know, there's a future for me doing this on the street corner in Cardiff. I'm sure I could get away with that. I really could. I really could. Number three. One of my favourites, that. One of my favourites. There we go. Just check the tune in. Yeah, it's still okay. Just do that up a minute. It's better. There we go. Right. Okay, I was up there. Fine. Ready? Number five? Okay. That's number five. Number six. Number six. But you didn't think a ukulele could get away with things, I guess, did you? Here we go. Number seven. Carried away with that one. One of my favourites. One of my favourites. Number eight. That was number eight. Number nine. That's number nine. Number ten, last one in the music round. Number So, what's happened to that one? What have you done? Never mind. I made do with it. I did it as a true professional. You've seen me many week with saxophone, harmonica, keyboard, guitar. The last guitar wasn't as successful as this one, but we did it. So, record that I was good at. You can send your requests in for any musical instrument and we'll consider it. I can tell you now. So, here we go. Answers are... Careless Whisper by George Michael. I don't need that to do it. Careless Whisper. Number one, Careless Whisper, George Michael. Number two was Another Brick in the Wall by Pink Floyd. Yes, you didn't know that one, did you? No. Number three was... Michael Jackson, Thriller! You couldn't guess that, could you? No, you couldn't guess that. Not even the music and me and the actions. You couldn't get that one. Number four. Classic from my days. Was Tears for Fears, Everybody Wants to Rule the World. Yes. I remember this out in the streets. Number five. Was Another Day in Paradise by Phil Collins. Yes!
Look like you're in paradise.
I feel like in bloody paradise, I tell you now. Another Day in Paradise with Phil Collins. Half a point for each, okay? That's number five. Number six. Louis Armstrong. What a Wonderful World. And what a wonderful world we can make it if we wanted to. Anyway, that's another story. Number seven. Was Let It Be by the Beatles. Singing words of wisdom, let it be. That was number seven. Number eight was Perfect by some bloke called Ed Sheeran.
But you don't know of a clue what it is.
No idea. Is he ginger? He's ginger, isn't he? He's bound to be. Tag a ginger friend this week. Let's support them. All right? Anybody who know ginger, send them a message. Say love you. Okay? That's done my bit to help gingers. Number eight. That's perfect. Number nine. Was Last Christmas by Wham. Yes, Last Christmas. Do you all remember that one?
Where we can meet up.
Where we can all get together in the same bloody house and drink sherry, stuff yourself with your turkey and the balls. What are we going to do this year, eh? Well, we're going to see ourselves through. We'll get through it. Trust me. And number 10.
Of course.
Is, of course, ending on Elvis, who couldn't help falling in love with you. Couldn't help falling in love with you. So that's the end of the quiz. You've had four rounds of 10 questions. PM me your scores to see who's going to win this week. See what you're going to win. Might be something very special. I don't know.
You could win that wig for
a start. Who knows? You can have this wig because I'm not wearing this again. No, I think I've outdone this wig. Right? The only time I'm going to use this again is for Johnny Bravo. Johnny Bravo, yeah, man. Yeah, man.
Johnny Bravo.
None of you know who Johnny Bravo is. So... We're going to play this week. We're not doing player cards, right? We're going to do spin the wheel.
Okay. We'll just
but play. We're going to ring somebody, okay, this week. That's Strike It Lucky. So this week we're going to ring somebody, right? Probably an Elvis fan, something like that. See what they want to do. See if they're going to play. Spin the wheel. They're going to have three chances this week. Three chances to spin the wheel.
Three prizes. No expense spared this week. Just to let you know, it does work. Whose phone's ringing? Don't forget, there's a delay, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, it's Auntie Sonia.
Auntie Sonia. Sugar mama.
Hello, gorgeous.
Right, listen, Auntie Sonia. I know you've got an Elvis fan in your house, haven't you?
Yes, we have an Elvis fan now.
You have an Elvis fan in your house. So listen, you're going to have to liaise with the Elvis fan.
Wait, turn the TV down, then. Sorry, but if it's confusion.
That's normal.
Do you know, Phil and Holly don't get this trouble when they ring people up. Do you know what I mean?
I know, sorry, darling. I know.
Right, so we're going to spin the wheel. You're going to have three chances this week, so I'm to spin the wheel, okay? Are you ready? Have you played this game before?
No.
No, I'll just put it on beginner level on the back a minute. Hang on, just
okay,
put the switch
thank
on.
You.
There we go. Right, so here we go. Do you want it hard or soft?
Woo-hoo! Soft, Kev.
Soft. Okay. That's a soft.
Kevin said he wants it hard.
I bet he would, yeah.
He said it's soft now. Ooh.
Ooh, just that's another spin. So I'll do a hard spin for
hard
Kev.
Hard or soft? Hard again, please.
Hard. That's a hard spin for Kev. Right, here we go. What's he going to win? Ooh, don't know. We don't know. Spin the wheel.
He's won five quid!
He's won £5! £5 he's won!
Got another spin yet?
You got one more spin! One more spin, so you could double your money for £10. Ooh! Here we go. Hard or soft? I assume that's hard. Here we go. You got five, you've won £5 already.
It's guaranteed.
That's in the bank, that's guaranteed. You can take that away with you.
He's got
a £10 again. He's won this week. We've got it again. He's won. Yes, I got rid of these fake fivers. We'll get them sent out by carrier pigeon to you. Don't you worry about that. I'll get it over to you. You need it. God bless you, Auntie Sam and Uncle Kevin. Mama. Sweet mama. Ladies and gentlemen, we have winners this week. Won £10. £10! No expense spared. So, are you going to be lucky next week? Are you going to send me your number? Are you going to help us enjoy ourselves? Okay? That's what it's all about, ladies and gents. During this lockdown is enjoying ourselves. It's been so hard for a lot of people. Right, everybody's struggling at the moment. Everyone's getting fed up. We just want to have a bit of fun, lighten it up for everybody. We've all got our own troubles in life, ladies and gents. Pauline, come here.
Hi, I'm not dressed for it tonight.
Here we go.
Hi, everyone. Bye, everyone.
Yes, she was behind the scenes today.
I'm behind it.
See you all next week for some another classic Mark's Crazy Lockdown Quizzes. God bless you all.